Put your gloves on.
Oh, well, that this one I need gloves.
You don't have to.
Cute little. Well, I do want to put gloves on. Yeah.
Here, take your gloves off.
I'm gonna keep the gloves on.
Or put your gloves on.
Okay.
This is a hedgehog.
Okay.
So as we're talking of wonderful adaptations, that's a lazier one. This is a busy one. The number one adaptation that you're gonna see here is that he's got quills.
Yeah.
You feel those quills?
I can.
So if he feels like a predator, if I feel a predator is coming, he'll roll into a nice ball like that.
Why does he sound like he's about to explode?
Well, that's part of his defense. So he wants to remind you, like, he's not really good at fighting away predators in any other way except for poking with quills. So he makes a noise, he jumps, and hopes that the predator goes, you know what, that's too spiky.
Do the quills jump off of his body into
you? No, he can't throw it. He has to thrust them into it.
And porcupines, can they throw theirs?
Nope, they can't. Everyone thinks they can, but they cannot.
Oh, yeah, because we watch cartoons and we think that's what
animals do. Yeah, they throw them, but they don't. So this is a great example. I always try to tell people these don't make good pets. All the animals you see me bring out, they're not good pets. And this is a good one where people think they're awesome pets. They're nocturnal. They don't want to play with you during the day. You know, typically,
but
this is
what
playing is.
But on late night shows, they like to be.
They don't mind because they know they're going to get tons of snacks.
Yeah.
When they come here, they get overfed. So
this
they
is what the Flintstones used to use to clean their pots and pans, right?
Exactly right. That's a wonderful scouring. So you can also see, as they're about to go away, they have nice short arms for digging holes.
Okay.
And you can hand that
feed
over.
Feed this
there.
To the lizard. Yeah.
So, Jimmy, I need you to come around.
Hey,
take your gloves
matata,
off.
Matata, you know?
Take your gloves off.
Uh-huh. All right.
Now, I want you to come around.
Okay.
And I'm going to try
God only knows what is about to come out now.
Come around with me. Here we go.
Holy, oh my God.
Now this.
Whoa.
Hey, big guy.
Oh, he's coming at us. All right.
There you go, big guy.
Why did he come at us like that?
Well, this is his stump. This is where he likes to be.
Okay.
So, come on, come around with me. Come around me.
I don't want to be that close to him.
Just in case I didn't tell you already, he's a vulture.
Yeah, I
can
see that.
Stay with me just because I want to keep
feeding him. Now, they only eat dead things, right?
Right, so they're scavengers. And we're talking adaptations. We're trying to get people so
interested. He doesn't mean when he says you're a scavenger, it's not an insult. It's just a technical term.
He is one of the best scavengers in the world, a vulture is.
So that's what they say. You're one of the best scavengers in the world.
So the things that he's adapted to. Here, big guy, come here.
What kind of beef is that?
Just regular old lean beef.
Smells like a horse.
Anytime we bring animals out here, we want them to be rewarded and have fun. He's obviously, come here, big guy, I wanted you to face the cameras.
Yeah. So why do they eat dead things only? Can they eat live things?
It's part of they can. They can hunt. They're not great hunters. If he does come off the stump, you'll see they're very slow. What they've adapted to do is they eat off of other things that the predators leave behind. So a big lion will eat a carcass. And there's still lots of meat. You see that big hooked beak that he has? He's going to be using. That's perfect for picking meat off of bones. Another thing that I think is super cool is they can smell a carcass from a mile away. So they use those big, see those big wings?
Yeah.
Those big flight feathers on the back.
Yeah.
They've adapted for them to be up soaring miles in the sky. They soar around. They don't even have to flap. They see something or they smell something. They come down on it and then they wait until the predator's gone.
It's kind of a good-looking animal, actually.
They're beautiful.
I'm complimenting you. Yeah. What's his name?
Dexter.
Oh,
I knew
good. You named him after a serial killer.
I'm going to try to, like, if I can move. Hey, big guy, come here.
He wasn't creepy enough.
Come here.
All right, well, let's take a break and let this guy go out in the parking lot and eat somebody or something. We are back with Dave Salmoni. Puppy Bowl 14 is against the Super Bowl on Animal Planet.
It absolutely is. It's one of our best shows. It's puppies playing. There's cheerleaders. There's kitty halftime.
Yeah, and is the porcupine on the...
Porcupine is not on it, but hey, any animal is a good animal in my book.
Mm-hmm.
This North American porcupine. You know, we're talking adaptations. We're trying to teach people how awesome conservation is. These guys are awesome. So if you feel you... If you
now,
pet
those
a porcupine,
are the spikes, right?
Way. So these ones are a lot softer, right? If you see on the head up here, see those little smaller spiky ones?
Yeah.
And then back in the tail there... There's the weapons. The big spiky ones are here. You see those there? But if you were to pet him this way, you'll get a sense for how soft he is.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
If you were to pet him.
He won't do anything weird?
Nice and gentle.
Do people use these quills for anything, like toothpicks?
Decoration, for sure.
Yeah.
Certainly.
Oh, he's very soft.
Yeah, so the interesting thing with these guys is they're, you know, it's only a defense, so they don't want to get you. This guy's super sweet. Look at that guy.
How do you know that, though?
How do I know he's sweet?
Well, how do you know they don't want to get you? If I was a porcupine, I'd want to get people.
They don't want to get anybody because they don't want to start any confrontation. The reason they're black and white is there's contrast. They want to warn everybody, hey, I'm dangerous. Just don't come near me. So if something does, we all think we talked about before, they don't throw their quills, they jam their quills. These quills actually go in very smooth, but if you try to pull them out, there's barbs. It's sort of like scales that'll stick in. So once they're in, they're in.
Oh, yeah.
They're staying in.
Yeah, I'm going to back away from the... is this more pork or more pine this way?
I'm not sure.
All right. Well, we're going to leave the porcupine
all right.
here.
I got one more fun thing for you.
Other animals that you're going to show us.
Okay, come on
These
over here.
These animals are adorable. Oh, now this is up my alley. This is the kind of animal I like.
Now, yeah. these are pot-bellied pigs. Now, do you want to hold one?
Yeah, I'll hold the
Put
pig.
Put your arm
yeah.
like a football.
Okay.
Pig's
oh, not like a football.
There
Don't
you
say
go.
Football.
Now, hold them nice and tight to your body. You're going to okay. see they're super comfortable.
Oh, my God, they're so cute.
Now, we were talking about the puppy bowl. These guys are the cheerleaders. We have pigs as cheerleaders.
Do they know they're the cheerleaders for the puppy
yeah,
bowl?
Of course they do. Who wouldn't? Mm-hmm. It's a big honor.
Yeah, you know, the wow. Look, stuff. They're eating my shoe.
Yeah. Well, the pigs are omnivorous. They'll eat almost anything.
Don't eat my shoe, guys. Hey, wow, they're really like eating
oh,
the shoe.
Get after
How
it.
Big will these pigs get?
These ones are pot-bellied, so they'll get, you know, maximum 20 pounds. But, you know, some pigs in the wild, they can go over 500, 600 pounds.
And why are they pot-bellied? Do they drink?
They're pot-bellied because they actually, when they get old, they actually do get a funny pot belly.
Yeah, right. Well, guys, you guys are going to be the cheerleaders, huh?
Yeah.
Can you do a pyramid? Whoa.